Greetings, brothers and sisters. I'm Professor Spira, and this is the Mucusless Diet Healing System by Professor Arnold Arrett. Diagnosis continued. Lesson 4. Fat and lean types. The bodily mechanism of the fat type is, on the average, mechanically more obstructed because he is in general an overeater of starchy foods. In the lean type, there is more physiological, chemical interference with the organism, such a one being in general a one-sided meat eater, which condition produces especially much acidity, uric acid, other poisons, and pus. Disease story. As a general rule, I ask my prospective patients the following questions, as the knowledge to be gained is of great importance. Number 1, how long have you been sick? Number 2, what did the doctor call your disease? Number 3, what was the nature of the treatment? Number 4, how much and what kinds of treatment taken? Number 5, have you ever been operated upon? Number 6, what other kinds of treatment have you taken before? Age, sex, whether a disease is inherited, etc., are important points. The most important thing, however, is the patient's diet at present, his special cravings for certain foods, and his wrong habits. If constipated, and how long? What kind of diets, if any, were used before? It is necessary to base the change in diet on the patient's present diet, and only a slight change toward an improved diet is advisable. The experimental diagnosis. The most exact, unerring diagnosis we have is a short fast. The more rapidly the patient feels worse through a short fast, the greater and the more poisonous is his encumbrance. Should he become dizzy, suffer severe headaches, etc., he is greatly clogged up with mucus and toxemias. If palpitation of the heart occurs, it is a sign that pus is somewhere in the system, or that drugs, even though taken many years ago, are in circulation for elimination. Any inside, special constipated place is located by a light pain there. The experimental practitioner can ascertain better than the x-rays through nature's revelation after a short fast the true condition of the inside of the human body, and knows the real diagnosis more correctly than doctors can ascertain with all their expensive scientific equipment and instruments. If this short fast diagnosis is tried on the average man called normal and healthy, but in reality clogged up with mucus, latent disease, nature reveals the same to you in a moderate degree, and if a weak point has begun to develop unsuspected by them, nature will unerringly indicate where and how he will later become sick if the wrong method of living is continued, although it may be after some years. If this short fast diagnosis is tried on the average man called normal and healthy, but in reality clogged up with mucus, latent disease, nature reveals the same to you in a moderate degree, and if a weak point has begun to develop, unsuspected by them, nature will unerringly indicate where and how he will later become sick if the wrong method of living is continued, although it may be after some years. This, then, is the prognosis of disease. Some special diagnosis. To show that all differently named diseases, even the most severe ones, have their basis and are caused by the same general and constitutional encumbrance of the body, I shall show you, in the light of truth, a few characteristic kinds of cases. through these illustrative examples, I shall prove that there is not a single disease, not a disturbance or sensation, not an unhealthy appearance or symptom which cannot be explained and seen at once in its real nature as local constipation, constitutional constipation by mucus and its toxemias, most of the quantities continually supplied from the chronic reserve stock of waste in the stomach, intestines, and especially in the colon. The basement of the human temple is the reservoir from which every symptom of disease and weakness is supplied in all its manifestations. A cold is a beneficial effort to eliminate waste from the cavities of the head, the throat, and the bronchial tubes. Pneumonia. The cold goes deeper and will eliminate and clean the mucus from the most spongy and vital organ, the lungs. A hemorrhage occurs to clean more radically. The entire system is aroused, causing higher temperature by friction of the waste in circulation. That proves alarming, and the doctor suppresses by drugs and food, actually blocking nature's process of healing, cleansing. If the patient does not die, the elimination becomes chronic, and it is called consumption. The consumptive patient eliminates continually his mucus caused from erroneously increased mucus-forming foods through the lungs instead of through the natural ways. This organ itself decays more and more, producing germs, and it is then called tuberculosis. The vital organ, lung, the pump, works insufficiently on the circulation. The entire cell system decays more and more and decomposes before the patient dies. Toothache. Its pain is a warning signal of nature. Stop eating. I must repair. There is waste and pus. You have eaten too much lime poor food, meat. Rheumatism and gout. Mucus and uric acid particularly accumulated in the joints. Since here is the less dependable part of the tissues for the passage of the circulation, heavily loaded with waste and uric acid in the one-sided meat eater's body. The stomach is the central organ of disease matter supply. There is a limit to the ability of this organ to digest and to empty itself after the meal. Every food, even the best kinds, are mixed with this acid mucus continually remaining in the average person's stomach. The wonder is how long the human being can stand such conditions. Goiter is a sane deposit by nature of tremendous waste to keep it from entering the circulation. A boil is a pimple, the same, only the elimination is outside. Stammering. Special accumulation of mucus in the throat interfering with the functioning of the vocal cords. I cured several cases. Liver and kidney diseases. These organs are of a very spongy construction, and their function is that of a kind of physiological sieve. They are therefore easily constipated by sticky mucus. Sex diseases. These have for their origin nothing more than mucus elimination through these organs and are easily healed. The use of drugs alone produces the characteristic symptoms of syphilis. The more drugs that have been used, especially mercury, the more carefully the treatment must be conducted. Ear and eye diseases. Even short or long sight is congestion in the eyes and trouble with hearing congestion of these organs. I healed a few kinds of blindness and deafness by the same principles. Mental diseases. Besides a congested system, I found that anyone mentally diseased has congestion, especially of the brain, One man on the verge of insanity was cured by a 4 weeks fast. There is nothing easier to heal than insanity by fasting. Such men, having lost their reason, their natural instinct tells them not to eat. I learned that if you heal by the mucus's diet healing system, all kinds of diseases. Most of the patients are relieved of greater or less mental conditions. After a fast comes a clearer mind. Unity of ideas comes to take the place of differences. Differences of ideas today are caused largely by diet. If something is wrong with anyone, look first to the stomach. The mentally diseased man suffers physiologically from gas pressure on the brain. Peace, love, and breath.